So it is generally useful for children who have attention deficit disorder and have compulsive disorders. And what you will see when tarantula child enters the cabin, no? One is, as I told you, very, very hyper restless. He keeps moving from here and there, there and here, and he just cannot be put in one stationary point. Second, what we observe about the child?
Abusiveness.
Abusiveness and striking. If you try to come in his way, then he becomes very, very abusive and striking. So typically what you will find the mother will complain is that the teacher very commonly tells us that this child is very, very disobedient. He creates lot of fuss in the classroom. He does not sit in one place. He keeps moving here and there, and we are not able to control him. Okay? He has this, okay. The child tends to be very restless in your office. He runs up and down. He has the inclination to touch and grasp everything. So he moves quickly from the left to the right, and the mother must limit the damage. You know, matlab, always there is tension. Ki ye kuch to todega. He will break something. He will kick something. He will damage something. So always there is the danger. Music can calm him down, but can excite him. Next. Fever, I think we learned this. During fever, there is abusiveness, anger, violence, hitting, striking, desire for fruits and sand, no appetite at all, restlessness, pace of relief, I already told you. Next. Position. Okay. Now, let us see some mental picture of tarantula. Up till now, what we learned, that the spider, with how it attacks a prey and how it catches hold of the prey. Now, what does this spider do when it is attacked, when it is threatened, when it sees danger? Okay, the first thing that the spider does when it is attacked is, first thing is to threaten. First thing what it will do is it will raise its first two limbs and it will portray itself like one big dangerous thing. Please don't come near me. If you come near me, I will bite you. So go away. Get away from here. That is first reaction. Suppose if it sees, but still the animal is trying to come near, it's trying to attack him. What it will do is it will run away and dig itself into the burrow and hide. Third thing, still if the attacker is coming, then it will portray itself like, I am very big, you will be harmed, don't come near. After that also if it attacks, it dies. Okay, so these are the three primary responses. First is what is to portray yourself like one big dangerous thing, you know. Second is to hide. Now, if you remember the case that I told you, or let's take Sir's case, Shankaran Sir's case, the first case of cough. What you saw in that child? What is the first thing he said?
Patient.
Huh? What did the child say to Sir? Hey Shankar, why are you not reducing my cough? Huh? So, one is, you see that there is suddenness, no? Suddenly and abruptly he says something that is out of the blue. You didn't expect something like this to come. What do you see in the second case, my case, of that child? When I asked him, hey, why don't you eat food? What did you do?
Mind your own business.
Huh?
Mind your own business.
What did he say? He said, mind your own, what do you have to do? Mind your own business. And then what did he say? If you ask me, I will
hit him.
Okay, so this is very peculiar of spiders. One is this behavior of threatening. You know, don't come near me. If you come near me, I will hit you. Don't come near me. Why are you asking me? This is not your business. Mind your own business. Okay, second is the suddenness or abruptness. Suddenly out of the blue they will start doing something. And this abruptness is very peculiar. In fact, they sense this constant sense of danger. Somehow it is being observed that spiders feel that something is going to attack them or something is going to harm them at any point of time. They sense a constant threat. Okay, so what has been written in proving is, I feel like I am walking on the street and suddenly I feel something is going to hit me and I just sit down. So if you see me doing this, what do you feel? What happened to you? Why did he sit down suddenly? So that is the sense. The abruptness comes out of this sense that I am going to be attacked. There is a constant threat, and because of this feeling of there being a constant threat, there is a constant reaction that is very, very violent or threatening. Okay, firstly, they will try to threaten you and don't come near me, just get away from me, I am not for you. They will try to threaten and get off. But if you still come near, then they can get violent. They can hit you, strike you, abuse you, all those kind of destructive actions. But again, there is a quality to the destruction also. Okay? The quality of the destruction that they do is by scheming, planning, or deceiving the opposite person. It is a very cunning type of or foxy kind type of behavior. Cunning foxy means what? Like for example, I want to harm someone. Okay, so what I do? I sit here. She wants to harm me. I am taking my lectures. How do I harm? Slowly, while I am seeing this, she'll get her leg outside and she'll keep it here. I as usual walk and I fall down. Okay? Oh, sorry sir, nothing else. Sorry. So what is it? One is, it is like a small action that will harm me, but it is like nothing happened. By mistake it happened. I didn't do anything. By mistake my leg was there. I am walking here and you pour some oil here and I fall down. Okay? That kind of, what you see? Mischievous planning. It is mischievous planning. It is to, what you say? Slightly harm the person. And make fun of him. It is to make fun of the opposite person. That kind of thing. Like one patient, what she said, doctor, my mother, she is having Parkinson's, okay? So she has no control over stool and urine. So suddenly she'll shout, I have to go to the loo. So I come, I take her, then I put her on the pot and I wait 5 minutes. Okay, done, mama? Yes, done. Okay, so let's go. So I pick her up and then we start going, and midway when I am taking her to the bed, she will pass. And I say, mama, what happened? I tricked you. And she makes fun of me. She says, see, I told you that my stool was over, but it was not over. So that kind of, what you deceive. Trick and mischief they do. Now, what happens when they are doing such kind of mischief and they are planning, scheming things? They tend to get in trouble. People tend to point fingers. You are the culprit. This is seen especially in children. And when you start to blame them, you know, what they see? Ore, why you are punishing me? I have not done anything. We all of us were there. That guy didn't fall off on his own. He was also there with me. He was also there to plan with me to hurt that boy. I didn't do it. He did it. And in spite of that, if you tell him, no, you are the person, then they feel very, very bad. And they become like, why only me? Why are you troubling me? No, you are doing it to me. And they are not able to take any kind of punishment. They are very, very sensitive. And once you punish them, then they get even more aggravated and they start to hit, strike, abuse and do all those kinds of things. Or what they will do is, they will start crying very loudly and run away into one room and sit in one corner. Okay, and you will feel this guy must be crying there. So you go to him and ask him what is happening. First thing you will observe is this guy is sitting in that corner and laughing. Okay. That is one thing. Second thing, what will happen is, suppose he is laughing and he sees that you are coming near me, then he suddenly starts to cry. And he starts to cry and he starts to ask the mother, mother, give me this. Okay, you scolded me, so you have to get me this, you have to get me that, you said you have to buy me that thing, you have to buy me that thing. So they get there, what they want, by what? Creating fuss and drama. Okay, this is another very important theme of spiders, that is feigning sickness. You know, they feign things. I'm hurt, I will show you I'm hurt, I'm actually not hurt. In front of public, I will show. Oh, you trouble me, I did not do this, this guy also was involved, all that I will do. But when I go inside, I'm happy, laughing there. Okay, enjoy. Like that lady, I told you of Parkinson's lady. First thing, you know, first interview, what she had done. I generally talk with the patient alone. Okay. Now this patient, she couldn't even walk. So they brought her and somehow they put her in that chair. So I said, sit. I thought she would not be able to talk. She was talking in very, very, very low voice. I couldn't even hear. I had to really come and sit beside her to hear what she is talking. I took brief history. And something happened that in between, you know, she would suddenly talk loudly and I could hear. So I thought maybe because daughter and son-in-law is here, she is not comfortable. I thought let me try for 5-10 minutes if she can talk with me alone. So I asked the daughter and son-in-law to go outside and wait. They go outside, she starts to cry. She starts to cry loudly. I'm like, what happened? She starts to cry and then, what happened? She says, I feel I'm going to die. I don't know, you will not die, we'll do something. No, but I feel I'm going to die. Why? So what if you are going to die? So she says, no, if I die, my daughters will not be able to live without me. They can't live without me. I said, why they can't live without you? No, they can't live without me. I'm telling you, they can't live without me. So I thought there must be some property issue. So they must be fighting. So I asked some property issues. No, I have nothing. Property issues. I said, your daughters fight. No, they go along very nicely. Then, what is the problem? No, she will not be able, they will not be able to live without me. I am very, very important person, you know. I am the one who keeps this family together. I said, okay, maybe she must be doing something. So I asked the daughter later, what is it? She's saying something. She says, doctor, ekdam jhooti hai. She talks all lies. I said, what happened? No, she is the one which spoils our relationship. Huh? She does not let us get alone. If we go out, we can't, I and my husband can't go out. We have to always take her with us. If we don't, then she creates such a huge fuss. And she is 85, she can't even walk, but she has to be there in the middle of things. Okay? So that is what is important. One is this thing of, you know, creating drama and faking things, you know. There's nothing like the daughters depend on her, nothing. You just fake. Just to what? For what? Just to develop importance. That I am important. They can't live without me. I have to be there. I am very, very important. Huh? You go outside, you have to take me. So there is lot of seeking for attention. Attention seeking and wanting to be constantly looked at. And if you are not looked at, then create drama. Then start abuse, hate, strike, become very violent. Feigning sickness, attractive. Attention seeking. Wanting to be attractive. We saw, no? The desire for colors, bright colors. Attractive. They want to be very, very attractive. Be the center. I am the center. All others have to look at me. Without me, nothing should happen. Like, doctor, if we went out, no? If we went out and came back, then she would yell, shout, okay? Then one day what happened? We got some guests. So guests came in and she saw, oh, guests have come. So she said, first thing she'll do, you know, once the guests come, she'll ask all of us to go inside. She'll ask all of you, go inside, guests have come, guests have come. And then she will be the only one who will be sitting and talking with the guests. If we come inside, she will tell us, ja chai bana. If another comes, tell you make and go and make snacks. Children, why are you here? You go and play. Huh? And she will not allow any of us to come into that hall. She will see to it that she is the only person who is talking. Nobody else should even enter that room. That is the amount of attention that tarantula needs. They have to be the center of attraction.